Hello friends, in this tutorial we will learn how to create an auto-scrolling textbox in tkinter or ttk bootstrap. Now here we are using tkinter, but we have also installed the tkinter theme extension known as the ttk bootstrap. As you can see in the window, you can see that the values are being slowly scrolling down. Now the newly created values are shown at the bottom while the old ones are pushed up. So the user is always aware about the latest values. So this is done using the scroll text box from the ttk bootstrap library. Now I'll tell you how to make this thing auto scroll. So we'll close this window and we'll start the tutorial. Now before this, you have to understand that we have to install the ttk bootstrap library using the pip installer. So you can also check out our ttk bootstrap tutorial, which is available on our YouTube channel. Now first we have to import the various constants and the libraries required to create a scroll text. So first we will make a simple example. So I'll run this particular program. So we have a text box and we have a button. So when I press this button, some text will come like this. Okay, so I'm going to press the button. So I'm pressing it 5 times. Now I'll press it again, but you can see that the text box is not updating. It is not showing the 6 and 7 like that. So what is happening is that all the values are pushed downwards by using the vertical scroll bar. You can scroll down and see that the values are being updated, but they are not shown to the user. So for that, we have to make some changes to the scroll text box. So we have to import the various things that are required for this one. So we'll create the text box here. Scroll text, height equal to 5, width equal to 50, all those things. Then we will pack it. Now I'll create a button. So when we press this particular button, text will be added to the text box. So whenever you click it, it will call the button one handler. So it will go here and it will update the count. So whenever you press 1, it will update the count and will insert that data into the text box like this one. So that is how it will work. Now to make our text box auto updating, you have to insert this particular line. So we have to use the C method, and we will tell the method that we have to show the end of the line. So if you put this one and run the code, this thing will auto scroll. I'll show you 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, like the latest values are shown here while the older ones are being pushed upwards. So in this way you can build a text box that will automatically show the latest value that is being presented to the user. Now that's one way to do it. Now this is an auto scrolling. I'm not pressing anything, but this thing is constantly being updated. So that is done by using the run.after method. So I'll tell you how it works. So everything is same. We are creating a text box here. Then we are calling something called as the update underscore function. This is the update function, this one. This will constantly update the text box. So we have a value called as count. Count is equal to 0. And inside this one, we are telling the function that we are using the global count and we are going to increment it once. So after the incrementation, we have to insert that value, that is auto scrolling text box, and the count value here. And then we have to call this particular line, textbox.c tk.end, so that the text box will display the latest value at the bottom. Now after that, it will come here and it will wait for 600 milliseconds. After that, it will call the update function again. Then it will come here, it will increment the count by 1, insert the new count in this line, and then we'll call this particular line, and it will show the latest value, which is at the bottom. After that, it will come here and do this thing again and again. So this is how the text box is getting auto updated. This is our website. You can find all sort of embedded system tutorial and products from our website. We manufacture things like USB to serial converter, USB data acquisition systems, and isolated USB serial, things like this one. So if you are interested, you can check out our store and you can buy these things and help us to support us. So we also have an online tutorial, for example, TTK Bootstrap, this one. So you can check that one if you want to. All the code are available on our website. So the source codes are available here and you can go to our GitHub and download from here. So do check out our website and do check out our online store if you're interested in learning about embedded systems.